All right, so the skeleton of this code is pretty much what you've already done before, but we're going to introduce a few other things here. First of all, we set this caller variable to be the caller of xhrget. Now, this is a special thing in JavaScript, and what it does is whoever ends up calling xhrget will be set as this xhrget.caller parameter, and you can grab that as necessary. Next, we do the same thing that we've done this entire time, create a new XMLHttpRequest and call the open method. Then we check the type. If it exists, then we set it. Otherwise, we assume by default that it is just text. Now, the onload function is where things get interesting. If we set a callback, then we go ahead and try and call it. Otherwise, we don't do anything. Now, this try-catch block is something that some of you might be familiar with. We try to do what is in this try block here, and if it fails, then we catch the error and throw an exception. Now, this is basically just going to print out a whole bunch of information about the exception. And this is where caller comes in as well. You can see that we print out the exception, the response text, and the caller just for debugging purposes. Finally, we call xhr.send, and that's it. And if we load this up in our browser, we can see we make both calls. The first one takes a lot less time than the second one, since it's only JSON. We can see our output JSON in the console, and our song starts playing.